Dear artists, I know that a lot of you are struggling to market yourself. Promoting illustrative art online is extremely difficult because, frankly, there is just way too much of it, and way too much of it is legitimately great, and so much of it deserves to succeed that it's difficult for it to penetrate the market without having some kind of gimmick behind it. A lot of artists find themselves struggling because they have to promote the art themselves. They have to sort of run a one-man show. If you need a YouTube channel to promote your art, you've got to run the YouTube channel. If you need to have a social media or whatever, it's all on you. And I know that a lot of artists are hugely introverted and don't have the easiest time communicating with others to try to collaborate or seeing the worth in their own art to have faith in it, to seek some kind of collaboration. But if you want to break into this market sincerely, if you are trying to have a career as an artist and you want to eventually be able to just do whatever you want and fuck off and go be an artist somewhere, you can do that by teaming up with people, at least for now. If you can find a way to gather people who you can cross-promote with and market yourself through them, then you can achieve a high deal of success that will make you into a popular artist. If you can launch a career by way of this collaboration, people will continue to follow your art into the future. First, let me give you some classic examples of what I'm talking about. One from the Western world of art, one from the East. I should note that obviously the most common way that artists work together with other creators is when illustrators do work for light novels or manga or comic books, anything where they're teaming up with a narrative artist. But because this is already such a gigantic market, even in the publishing world, because there are already so many companies making connections between artists and writers and pumping out books, it is much harder for that kind of content to succeed online. Every once in a while, there's a breakout web novel that takes off, and that artist will be able to develop a career on the basis of their continued involvement in the series, if they continue to be involved in the series. But there are other mediums, such as YouTubers and musicians and other things that I'm going to talk about in this video, that are much more common to the internet and will be a lot more helpful for an artist who doesn't have any connections to any kind of industry to get promotion through. Our Western story is of the band Gorillaz, a multinationally famous hitmaker who produced three classic albums and no shortage of massive singles: Clint Eastwood, Feel Good Inc., etc. This band was built out of a collaboration between a musician and an artist, the same artist who had previously made the comic book Tank Girl. So already a famous artist at this point, which is why he was chosen for this collaboration. However, it's what this would lead to for him that I think makes it worth talking about. Because the Gorillaz launched as a fictional band, where the character designs that this artist had come up with were translated into a band who was supposedly performing these songs, even though most of these were like hip-hop songs that aren't even performed with traditional instruments, nor even feature them in the instrumental. But nonetheless, this was the fictional idea of the Gorillaz, and they went all out on making animated music videos showing this band performing and having like crazy adventures. They built a narrative around it. They had writers on board for this. They built a crazy webpage that was way ahead of its time in terms of interactivity, that had all kinds of story elements and fucking games on it and shit. And so basically they crafted this entire narrative around these character designs. I mean, for the artist, all he had to do was sort of invent this world and characters, something that I'm sure he wanted to do because he had this idea, but he didn't have to actually, like, make the music that these characters perform. By bringing life to that through this other artist, through Damon Albarn and everyone who worked on the Gorillaz albums, they were able to promote this artwork in a much bigger way, in a way that would reach a huge audience, because a viral pop song is going to reach a lot more people than just a really nice piece of artwork, even if it's like really incredible and from a famous artist. This blew this guy up, and now he can do literally whatever the fuck he wants with his art. You could just make a gorilla's art book. You don't even have to draw anything new for it if you don't want to. Just put all the images into a book and sell the book. Or do an art exhibit at a museum because, hey, it's gorilla's art. Here it is up on display. People will pay to see that. That dude could live forever off of just gorilla's art, and he keeps making new shit for it, and his art keeps evolving, he keeps aging the characters, he's continued the narrative over the course of 20 fucking years of having these characters age and progress in their storyline. Obviously, the man is, like, probably quite well-to-do after being a part of such a massively fucking successful series, and as far as I know, not having been contractually fucked over, but, you know, who knows? I don't know, unless I've heard that I can't say for sure. Meanwhile, in the East, we have beautifully operated examples of this in the form of Hatsune Miku, and then all of her offshoots. Hatsune Miku is designed by an artist called Kei, who is basically just like any other Pixiv artist. They have their own distinctive style, and they draw really great character designs, but it's not any different from what could have been the illustrations for some manga or light novel or anything else. But this company picked up on this character design, and were like, we're gonna use this as this pop idol that we're going to fucking storm the world with, and all we're gonna do is just build a voice pack of her voice and let people make their own songs with it. So Hatsune Miku is entirely propped up by fan content of this program. So this is where a studio that develops sound programming teamed up with a fucking Pixiv artist to create a fictional idol. They created a monster. Then they followed this up with the Miku Miku dance program, which allowed anybody to just take a simple model of the Vocaloid characters and make them dance. This explodes through the internet, and so now everyone's making their own videos and their own songs out of Hatsune Miku. Any ambitious musicians out there who want to also cling to this artist as a means for their success, now that the artwork at the center of it is taking off, then musicians are attaching themselves to that. And this is where we get the artist Ryo. Who creates Supercell. Supercell is a group where this very ambitious musician who is just crafting his own Hatsune Miku songs that are all like extremely pop sensible. They're all built perfectly around classic chord structures, classic melodies. One of them is just a Linkin Park song. They are perfectly crafted pop and pop rock songs. He launches these by taking different artists from Pixiv who are drawing great Hatsune Miku artwork, attaching them to the individual songs and representing the attitude of those songs through these different artists. And therefore, all of these different interpretations of Hatsune Miku, because these songs are so successful, end up developing their own followings and their own cults of personality. Here's where we get to Black Rock Shooter. Obviously, the Hatsune Miku artist is successful forever now. I have a K art book that I bought that is, I think, available in Barnes & Noble. It's very widely available because a lot of people want Hatsune Miku fucking shit. Manga artists can just attribute themselves to this character. They can just attach themselves and just ride into being able to write manga just by attaching themselves to Hatsune Miku and putting out some fucking corporate manga for people to collect, because this character is so huge that she can just literally build careers out of nothing. And so Ryo, attaching himself to Hatsune Miku, attaches this artist Huke, who has a character design that happens to look kind of like Hatsune Miku, named Black Rock Shooter, who he asks him to redesign to look more like Hatsune Miku so that they can use it in this video with the Hatsune Miku song. Video blows up, goes super viral on Nico Nico Doga. Now, this interpretation of Miku has its own fan base, and there's tons of fan art and shit coming out of this character. Now more people want to make songs about this version of Hatsune Miku. Because of the fact that the company at the center of Hatsune Miku is trying to sort of maintain the purity of this character, it's important to them that they do not give too many defining attributes to Hatsune Miku, because if they do, then it'll color the way that people interpret the character. They'll stop making her so flexible. So they will not publish an anime of just Hatsune Miku goes to high school, because that would just totally ruin the creativity surrounding the character. However, any of these offshoots that are obviously unofficial, they're all fair game, because you can just market that as an alternate version of the character, and it preserves the sanctity of the original, and more alternate versions can continue to be made. So, when BlackRock Shooter becomes really popular, they team up with an ambitious studio, or Dent. This is another studio who is run by this guy, Yamakan, who happens to be a marketing genius. I am sort of the Yamakan of anime YouTube, in a way. I'm like this weird guy who somehow understands marketing, but has the worst PR of all time. And like, just publishes every thought that comes into my head, and makes lots of people hate me. But like, I do understand, like, the marketing side. I'm just terrible at, like, implementing it in my own life. But Yamakan is a genius at marketing, and he recognized that he could also cling to this growing trend and publish an OVA that they could really sink a lot of money into and still make a return on it. The BlackRock Shooter OVA is, like, 45 minutes long. It's beautiful. It's really entertaining. I loved it at the time. I happen to have two DVDs of it because of the fact that these fucking geniuses decided to package a cheap, shitty DVD of the movie into every BlackRock Shooter figure fucking sale. So if you bought any BlackRock Shooter figures, which me and my brother Shade bought like six between the two of us because we loved this character design. I love Huke's artwork. By the way, Huke then went on to design Stein's fucking gate and just doubled down on unbelievable success for this artist just by being attached to these franchises that take the fuck off. But Stein's Gate is a lot more traditional. It's an artist working for a game company. BlackRock Shooter's like some guy who's basically a YouTuber, but for the Japanese version of YouTube, just coming up to you and being like, hey, can I use your art in my song video? Sure. Oh, now you're a multinationally famous fucking artist. You gotta try to make those connections. Like, that's what's going to help you to take off. Now, here's an untested idea that I'm going to propose. And I don't think this is gonna make anybody super famous, but if somebody can successfully launch this to at least, like, a decently successful Patreon, and then they can fund further expansion on it into other mediums through that success, then this could snowball into a very successful career. But the right artist has to do this. Don't try to do this if you're not actually a good artist, but you know who you are. Or maybe you don't know who you are, but if all of your friends are telling you that you're, like, really, really good, and they're, like, people with good taste, like, find friends who are harsh critics and get them to tell you that your art is great. That will be when you know that you have, like, you are good, whether you know it or not. Step one, let's team up with cosplayers. I think it would be really interesting if we had people who were making character designs that maybe would translate into great outfits, then have cosplayers design those outfits and showcase them. I think it would be like a really creative way to just like invent two different facets of this character at the same time, the original illustration and what it would be interpreted like in real life. Now, if you can find any success in this avenue of like combining your artwork with that of like a cosplayer or anyone else, any of these other ideas I've posited, if you're, you know, teaming up with a musician, if you're teaming up with just someone who's a little bit more marketable or operating in a market that is less saturated than that of illustrative art, which is pretty much any market on the internet. Team up with a YouTuber. I know a few artists who've gotten huge boosts to their careers because of the fact that they've designed my banners and avatars. My friend Munchie gets tons of commissions because people know what his fucking artwork looks like. They see it all the time. I know Cappy gained a lot of followers on Tumblr after I showed off this art of me and May that they designed. If you can achieve some success from that teamwork through, say, Patreon or something like that, I would encourage you to invest in continuing to keep this buildup going, to continue adding more elements to the pile. Why the hell am I going out of focus? I'm like just a blur now. Anyways, I've pretty much made my point. Keep building onto your narrative like the gorillas did and other stuff like that, and you can definitely use those connections to help to prop up yourself as an artist, even on the smallest scale. Even if you're just an artist on Twitter and you have friends on Twitter who are starting up musicians who are only on Twitter. I know a lot of people who, like, a musician who's been trying to break out for 3 years and just hasn't really broken past the barrier of who their Twitter followers are as their audience. If you can team up with other people who are in that sort of situation, that collaboration might lead to something. If you can combine your sort of markets and create a narrative out of it. Anyway, I've rambled long enough. Somebody try this.